Ooh, it's a bit aggressive. I think that's, he just knocked the door off our Jeep. So today we're going to be building our very own Jurassic Park in the UK. And look at that beautiful coastline. We must be like Cornwall or something. Like, trying to think of somewhere that pretty in the UK. But there are places. And as you may notice, we have a load of buildings here that are already pre-built. And basically, there was a park here before that's been destroyed. And I'm going to get rid of some of this stuff because we just aren't going to use it. I'm going to demolish this little paddock here because it's way too small. We've got a hats building, so they sell hats here, which I'm going to deactivate because we don't actually have any guests yet. And it's obviously broken. There's been some serious damage. So we will fix that. Then we've got our science center over here. Our control center, sorry, not our science center. This is going to need fixing if we're going to control anything. And we've got a backup generator. So I'm going to go press R and get into the ranger team, which is our main people. And I'm going to repair these broken buildings just by just driving up to them and fixing them. So the rangers do a lot in your park. They're kind of like the people on the ground. They have a lot of responsibilities. And one of them is fixing all the buildings. So I'm just going to pay quite a lot of money to fix all this stuff. And I am going to... Oh, look, there's a dinosaur. Oh, my goodness. Already found our first dinosaur. Look at a little guy. So, as you can tell, there's already dinosaurs on the island that are roaming free. And we probably should sort that out before guests start coming. I'm going to fix this paddock up at the top of this little section. Just initially, so we have somewhere to put them. I am going to change this because I don't really think this is a great paddock either, but it's definitely better than the other one, which we just destroyed. I'm going to repair the viewing gallery as well, because the best way to start making money in this game is to let guests see dinosaurs, fairly simply, and this viewing gallery is going to let us do that. I'm probably going to move it around here though, so they can get a bit more of a view, because the viewing galleries have an arc. Oh, it's not showing yet, but they have like an arc viewing area, so want to get the most of that and do it up there. So far though, all these buildings are fixed. One thing I'm going to do is I'm going to reskin our ranger team something cool. So we could go for a ranger team from Jurassic Park. I think we've got to actually. Let's do Jurassic Park and have worn Jurassic Park skin. And then we can have, we'll keep the blue for the helicopter. And it's going to change back at any second. There we go. Now when we drive, hey, we're in a beat up little Jurassic Park car. So there we go. We can use that. As I said, there are some dinosaurs on the map. I'm going to go jump into the helicopter now and let's go capture some. We can get our very first dinosaurs. Now, I thought I saw some over here, but yes. See, we can get some of these big boys in. I'm going to go press R again and then we can dart some of them and then be able to transport them. Yeah, that's all right. We're not hurting them.
I'm a scientist. Some might call me an artist, a sculptor. My sculptures are living, breathing dinosaurs.
Yes, you're also a very bad person, but we're not going to go over that, Mr. Wu.
Was originally discovered in fossilized form in the Republic of Niger, hence the name. Now, it lives thanks to our efforts and our science. Notice the long tail, the flat skull. However, this dinosaur is smaller than some of its cousins. Now that we have them to study, perhaps we can learn why.
I think they're probably plenty big enough for us to start. Look at them. Oh, they look a bit sad when they've been sedated. Basically, we're just going to get some choppers to fly them in and drop them in here. And I'm going to move this viewing gallery so that guests could actually see from within it. So I'm going to press Z to flip it over. And yeah, I might put it there. See, what I might do actually is just... Oh, we don't have any fences, so I can't extend the fence line. I am just going to move it there. Let's put it just about here. And then it's going to need power, so let's put another backup generator over here. I'm hoping we can get rid of backup generators at some point, because they're very expensive. They're a very expensive form of power.
Now this dinosaur, the Dracorex, is something strange. Its name means the Dragon King of a fictional school for wizards. I think I could have come up with that myself. The name, not the dinosaur. For that, we need the scientists.
I'm just going to build a provisional little path that connects it so people can actually go and have a look at them if they want. Now I'm going to get into the chopper again and let's go catch some other dinosaurs, because we can go get one of those little ones that we saw before. Oh, it's over there. Oh, I think there are already some in there. Oh, there we go. Let's save getting them as well. I think that's probably just one dart per annum off of these. Yeah. Okay, let's go find some more though. Because it says on the little bar at the top that there's more over here. So... ah, there's loads. Almost flew into a tree then. Okay. Let's just dart all of these. Then we can get started on our first little habitat for these guys. Whilst we are making a dinosaur park, and like it will be somewhat like Jurassic Park, I do want to kind of have a little emphasis on the welfare of the dinosaurs, because I don't think they were treated very well in the films. And you know, we can make a nice little habitat for them. A bit more Planet Zoo style. Let's get these in here. At the minute, I'm sure they're very unhappy. Let's just plunk them all in. Come on, where's the last one? Put you in there. I think that's all of them. And then we can get our ranger. Get ranger team one. Oh look, there's already people in. So now they know there's dinosaurs to see. Yeah, take a photo of the ranger team. That's normal. Let's go. Oh, there's no way in. We need to build a gate. So let's come out of the ranger team and put a gate just there. Now we can make our way in. Because we need to check up on the status of the dinosaurs. So as soon as you get a dinosaur in Jurassic World Evolution 2, you need to check up on the status of them with your rangers. See how much your rangers do already. And this basically just tells you how well they're doing in the habitat and like what requirements they have. So let's just quickly status check all of these guys. Or at least as many as are in here. And when the others arrive, they're going to have the same needs as the other Dracorex that are in here. At the minute, they're a bit lonely as well. But the comfort rating is the main thing. So at the minute, we want our dinosaurs to be as comfortable as they can so they don't break out for one, but also so they have a good life. And they have certain requirements. They all need water, and these guys are going to need forest and ground fiber. So when we come into the environment tab, we can place some water firstly. Let's put like a little pool over here. We can make it a bit nicer in a bit when we expand the enclosure, but then we can also get some forest. There's like a couple of trees normally that do forest. Yes, there's two different types of forest, but I think this is probably going to look nicer. And then we've got ground leaf, ground fiber. It just basically tells you what you're going to get from the plants. So it's a really cool way to make habitats, because you can essentially build it your own way. I'm going to put some forest at the back here, because I don't want to put forest in front of the viewing area. Otherwise, no one's going to see it. And then we put some ground fiber over here. Maybe some right here, so they come to see the guests. And basically, when they have enough in their territory, it'll all go into the white area and they'll be happy. At the minute, they're 98% happy, because it's only the ground fiber. They're just missing a tiny little bit. But you can see their territory there. And they've not quite explored all this area, so that might actually be okay. So what I'm going to do is let him carry on exploring, and then we can have a look at what these guys need. Oh, we haven't status checked them. They need ground nut and ground leaf. Okay, they have enough water though. So let's get some ground nut and ground leaf. We saw ground leaf earlier, so let's get some of this. We can just put this in over here and in here. And then I think ground nut is... annoyingly, with ground nut, there's only one plant that does ground nut, and it's this one. And it also does tall nut, which we don't actually need, but we'll put some of this in. And then they hopefully will have enough. One thing I'm also going to do, so we can status check them kind of automatically, is put a ranger post in, which is, just show it clearly, the ranger post. It's fairly cheap. And essentially our rangers will drive in and then they'll just status check every animal within this radius. So I want it to capture the whole habitat, and then we can select ranger team one, add task, and assign them to this ranger post. And then they'll just do it periodically. We won't have to constantly do it manually.
Hey, my name is Isaac Clement, and it's Hi, great Isaac. To finally meet you. I hope you're ready, because the dinosaurs can't wait to meet you too.
So we've got challenges we need to do, essentially, in challenge mode.
That's what I've got. More challenges in the form of a new objective.
Yeah, so we can pick our objectives. I think maybe we should do this amenity coverage. And this is going to be to put guest buildings in. And I think we're going to be doing that relatively soon. Look, so I'm going to choose that one.
Guests are repeat customers. Let's keep them as comfortable as possible.
We just need to make our drink coverage 80%. So we'll handle that in a little bit. But just to start, we need to make sure our dinosaurs are happy. So we've assigned a ranger team and they're probably, yeah, on their way already to go check them out. And that's going to be good because then we can actually see what they need. Seems like they're pretty close on everything. It would help if we can make the habitat bigger. But for now, we just need to kind of do what we can. And just kind of Tetris some plants in here for them until they're happy. See this guy. Yeah, this guy's happy. So needs slightly more water, but I'm not sure if they've... Oh, they have explored it all. Okay. Let's just get a little bit more water then. Not worried about it too much. Ooh, it's a bit aggressive. I think that's, he just knocked the door off our Jeep. One other thing you can do as well, which can get you extra money, is when you're in the, oh, I've done a bit of damage to the fence, because they weren't happy. One other thing you can do is if you press F, you can take photos of your animals, and you get money. So we just earned 174 grand for doing that. And you can keep doing this, just keep taking the same photo, but every time you're going to earn less and less because of a species repetition penalty, which kind of just stops you from just doing this on repeat.
At least we know you're pretty good with a camera.
So we won't keep doing that, but that's got us a reasonable amount of money so we can start doing the next bits we need to do. And one of those is going to be to get better stuff. If we go into operations, we need to build a science center so we can actually start researching some new things and improving our park. And I'm gonna extend this path up here and try and keep it fairly symmetrical and see if we can get this so a couple of like staffy buildings on this side to align over here. And this is where my OCD is gonna kill me on this to try and get it straight, because it's not as good as games like Planet Zoo with its path placement and like buildings aligning. But you kind of just got to do what you can. And once we've built this science center, we can start researching new stuff. I'm actually just going to change it from control center to one to control center. And same with arrival point, because we're only going to have one of these anyway. So you can change all the names of your building. You can literally call them whatever you want. We can call it response for the facility one. We could call it capture guys. Like, it can literally be whatever. Let's call it response team though. What was it? Facility. Won't mess with it too much. No, we can always have a second one. We can change the name. But Science Center is going to be Science Center. And now we can view research. So there's a number of things we need. One of them is going to be power, because I want to get a better power solution than we have at the minute. But we need more of this icon, which is a logistics icon. And that comes from your scientists. So all of the scientists in the game, at the minute we have two, have different skill points. So this Grover is better at logistics than he is at genetics and welfare, whereas Pandy is better at genetics than she is at logistics or welfare. So they're not really specialists in anything at this point because they're very low level, but they also have different potential. So Grover can actually eventually have 6 points in logistics, where you can only have 4 in welfare. So they're kind of good at different things. And you can read a little bio about all of them as well, which is quite nice. So it's Wyatt Grover. We can change his name as well to whatever we want. But essentially, they all have like a trait, which is like their special ability, and he's going to reduce the cost of research for us. So that's going to be really helpful in the early game for us, because we don't have a lot of money and we do need to do a lot of research to unlock all of the items we're going to need. But essentially, he gained a degree in the theater from Harvard. Wow, he's a smart boy. And he's been with the team for 6 years, joining after uni. So he sounds like a good egg. And we've got Pandy, Anna Pandy, and she's a positive influence. So if she works on the same job as another scientist, we're going to reduce the time that it takes to do the task by 20%. And she's also gone from Harvard. Maybe they know each other. And had a degree in paleontology. She's climbed some of the world's highest mountains, so she's a bit of a daredevil, and they're both from Harvard. I don't think we're going to have many stupid people on our team, if I'm honest, but it would be nice to get a bit more representation from everyone who didn't go to Harvard. But, you know, I guess they're the best, or they're one of the best, aren't they? Let's go. We need someone who's better at logistics. A generalist, whilst not actually very helpful in the later game, might be just what we need, because they've got 3 logistics, 2 genetics, and 2 welfare. So it shows you their cost per minute as well. It's something we're going to have to consider. But at a level 1, to have these traits, that's kind of what we need. So I might get a generalist, which goes against everything I stand for, because normally I hate the generalists because they're just not particularly good at anything. But she moved a lot as a child. They joined the company after tiring of a long career in the automobile industry. Away from work, they enjoy studying marine life while scuba diving. Well, hopefully we'll be able to get some lagoons in our park, and then she'll be able to fulfill a lifelong dream. Let's get her, and then we can actually start doing some research. So we can improve the power. But actually, the first thing I think I want to do is get some fences so we can improve that habitat we've got. And I'm going to whack this one, Pandy, on this because... Ooh, do we go for the cheaper research? Or... the positive. I'm going to go for the cheaper research and go with Grover. Even though Pandy's a positive influence and she's going to reduce the time it takes, I think we should go for the cheaper stuff because, you know, money and everything. So we haven't actually unlocked guest attractions, or we have got some guest amenities. So we could do this now. This is what our objective is. And at the minute, we've only got a hat store. So there are 3 types of guest amenity. There is food, drink, and shopping. And hats falls under shopping. But we need to increase our drinks coverage. And if you hover over where you're going to place it on the path, if I can think of the word, that's how it gives you an estimate as to how many guests are going to shop in there. So we can only fit 200 guests in here. 125 is definitely good enough. So I think I might put a food shop just here. And then we can configure it. So at the minute, we're going to get... This is the local interest. So these are the types of guests we have and what percentage of them are going to be likely to shop in here, really. So we really need to be appealing to general, which is this white one, and the natural... What are they? I'm trying to think of the names. Let me get them up. If we go to the overall screen... it says general, adventure, nature, and luxury. So these are the Richie Richardsons. These are the ones who care about us having good animal welfare. These are the ones who want to, like, go look up massive monsters in the lagoons or get in a gyrosphere and walk around with carnivores or something crazy. And these are the general ones who just want to see dinosaurs. They just care about having lots of dinosaurs. And to be honest, that's probably what we're going to give them. So donuts will probably work well because we're appealing to the... Yes, we are appealing to the daredevils, but we're also going to get the general and the nature, which is our bread and butter at the minute. And then we can put different modules in here, which are just like things to flesh out your store. And I'm going to pause the game quickly so we don't go too quickly and run out of money while I explain these things. But essentially, all of these will appeal to different types of guests. And I'm going to do the ones that are going to give us the most profit because it gives you an estimate as to how much you're going to make. And at the minute, that's fossil display is definitely going to give us the most because it's going to benefit the general and the nature guys. So let's put in something else. Ooh, seems like... A fish tank seems like a good shout, and then maybe something for the others. So let's go an ice cream machine, and then we can also design what our shop looks like. So I think for this game we should go with, we've got, hold on, these trees are in the way. So at the minute we've got Jurassic Park style, we've got Jurassic World concrete, and we've got Jurassic World panels. And I quite like the panels, so I think we're going to go with panels for this park. Or should we go... Maybe we should go Jurassic Park, because we are building Jurassic Park. Yeah, I'm changing my mind. We're going Jurassic Park. We'll go original. Concrete roof or concrete with parapet, if I'm pronouncing that right. I'm going to go with that, because that's nice to have the little plants. And then let's get a Jurassic Park entrance. Maybe we should go... Let's go large Jurassic Park, right there, in the middle. We can change where the entrance is going to be. You can also do it at an angle, but let's go middle, and then we can have... Seeing as it's food, maybe... No, it's a donut shop. You're not going to have seating on the roof, are you? You could have seen him with a canopy, I suppose. Just looking at the options. Or do we go for the classic thatch roof? What was that one? Thatch 2. I'm thinking maybe we go with something like these metal triangles or something a little bit edgy, because that's quite cool. And then we could keep it with lights and planters at the front. Yeah, let's go lights and planters. I'm gonna have a donut sign. Though we do sell ice cream here too. Ooh, no, we'll go donuts. We're mostly selling donuts. And we can also change our colors. So let's make a new color palette for this park, and then we can save it and use that for all our buildings automatically. And I think a cool color to go with, maybe purple. We can get a nice purple color as our main color. And then secondary could be a dark purple. Our roof could be like a really light purpley color. Yeah, let's have a little bit purplier. And then the decoration, I'm just trying to think what about the color wheel. What's the opposite? Yellow goes nicely with purple. Ooh, maybe not that yellow. Maybe we should. I'm trying to think what's the best yellow. That's kind of orangey. Maybe we'll go with this, but we'll change the metallic triangles. And then the lights could be purple. We're basically just going purple. I don't know why purple is our color, but apparently it is. Let's see what it looks like with other things. I think that looks better. Let's put in these lights. They look cool. And then we'll go save as default. And then whenever we place a new building, it's going to automatically have this color. I'm just going to call it donuts. Yeah, I can't think of a clever name for donuts currently. And then we do have to change it for this one though, because this is already built. So let's just select our recently applied colors, cycle through, and then we can also customize our hat shop. So let's get some Jurassic Park, put the parapet on. Will you please tell me in the comments if I'm pronouncing that right or not. Let's go large Jurassic Park in the middle, wooden columns. Yeah, sure, we'll have wooden columns. And then we can have canopies, they're quite cute. And leisure wear. I suppose it's better than formal wear, isn't it? It's a hat shop. And we could open this. We're going to be earning some money. And we're going to continue to sell hats, because that's cute. And we're going to put, yeah, probably put the same things in. I think, let's put a fish tank in again. I love a fish tank. And maybe a selfie spot. Take a selfie with your hat on. That'd be cool. And we'll just call it hats. Or hats. Because we're, you know, say it twice, makes it better, apparently. And let's put, finally, the drinks in. This is what we were going for. We could put it facing this way, but I think I might do a little entrance thing here. So let's just move it along. Put it right here. I'm going to press play so we can actually build. And we'll be selling ginger beer. Oh, should we sell ginger beer or root beer? At the minute, we're appealing mostly to nature, so let's do ginger beer. And then we'll just put the same... Let's put a fountain in this one. And a selfie spot again. They can take a selfie with their beer. With their ginger beer. And then we're going to put similar on again. I'm going to do large Jurassic Park in the middle. Let's put some... Maybe we should do the wooden columns again.
This park is really starting to take shape because of you.
We got one star. Basically, your star rating is how much money you're making. So because we're putting more shops in, we're going to be making more money. I'm going to put lights and planters at the front again. And I'm going to change these to be the same metallic columns because I like those. And again, it's just going to be ginger beer.
That's another objective down. You're really making a name for yourself.
But can you see how they've automatically put the colors in? It's just so helpful to have that. So we don't have to change the color palette ever again. We can just leave it with this interesting purple and yellow we've got going, which I actually quite like. The more I look at it, the more I like it. So we're going to leave it. That's the sound of a storm. We have a storm warning and we don't have any emergency shelters.